What is going on, guys? We are back playing some more Surviving with IndustrialCraft 2. Now today, guys, we're going to be messing around with duplicating items. Yes, we are going to be duplicating items, and no, we are not going to be cheating to do this. IC2 actually has a method through which you can duplicate items, and you don't actually pull them out of thin air, you pull them from energy. Pretty much pure energy. So if you remember a couple episodes ago, we messed around with the production of UU matter, which is currently still going on down here. And I mentioned that UU matter stands for universally usable matter. Now, essentially you can use this to make whatever items you want. Now there are limits. Certain things cannot be duplicated, but if it can be scanned, it can be duplicated and it will have a cost in UU matter to duplicate. There are a couple machines involved in this, but essentially you get the UU matter from raw power, you scan an item, and then you can turn the UU matter into that item. So that's why a lot of the power that we've been generating recently has been going to creating UU matter. So right now we're sitting at 61 millibuckets. I've been on here for a while. It took like 3 to 5 hours to prep for what I was doing today, so I was able to generate a lot of this. It would have been a lot better if I had had a lot of scrap to put in there, but I have not been consistently refilling this, so that is one downside. But this is enough UU matter to duplicate, say, a diamond or something. Unfortunately, it's only half of the UU matter we need to duplicate a piece of iridium. Now, iridium is probably 90% of the time going to be what you want to duplicate, because iridium is pretty much the hardest material to obtain in IC2, and it's probably going to be one of the more useful ones when it comes to higher tier crafting. So if we want to go and look up, I believe it's called the quantum armor. So if we look this up, you can see that there's this quantum suit stuff, which is pretty much the best armor you can get in here. And it's really fancy and it's fun to mess around with. But this stuff takes iridium reinforced plates. And this, of course, requires a lot of iridium. Now you can duplicate the iridium ore, or you could duplicate an iridium reinforced plate. But of course, you got to do the iridium first, because chances are you don't want to go and find 4 iridium ore. So I mentioned that it took roughly 3 to 5 hours to prep for what we're doing today, and you can see that there's an additional chest here. That is because today's episode is going to require a lot of work, a lot of material, and it was super expensive. I did a ton of mining, and I had to search all over the place to actually find one piece of iridium. Considering you don't actually mine it now, you find it in dungeons, and I believe you can find it in villages. I found it in a dungeon chest, but I think I've heard that you can find it in villages too. So I had to find that. I had to do a ton of mining to get resources for the machines we got to make, and then I came back and processed those, so it took a while. And I want to say right now that I'm probably not going to have a video up for maybe like 3 days, because I do have a chemistry exam at 6 in the morning on Friday, so I'm going to be spending most of my time studying for that. I hope you guys don't mind, but that's why we're doing this special episode today. So if we look in these chests, there's a lot of stuff going on here in this one and in this one. They're both pretty much filled to the brim. Granted, they could be a little bit less filled if I decided to stack these, but instead I've separated them out to help me understand where things need to go. But there is a lot of stuff that needs to be done, and we're most likely going to start here, because we are going to make the scanner today, which is probably the first thing that we should make. So we have the scanner, and this one's actually not super expensive. It does require we make a couple different parts, such as the illuminator and reinforced glass, but aside from that, there's not too much we need to make, so we're just gonna grab a good amount of the stuff out of here. I'm trying to remember what we even need for this. So the illuminator is gonna require this stuff, the copper cable, we got the glass in there, we got these, we need to get some of the electronic circuits, and most of these are gonna be turned into the advanced circuits, just because I don't know, I didn't feel like crafting those. I try and do a lot of crafting on camera so you guys get a sense of how much things cost. I always say that, but I do some crafting if it's gonna overwhelm me. Like, crafting all the electronic circuits would take a while. So I think that's everything we need. I hope so. We need actually some iron plating. Let's grab the iron plating out of here. So this is the first one. So we're gonna start things out by crafting 2 of these. Now, I don't wanna craft all of them right now, just because we might need regular electronic circuits later. I believe we do somewhere in this whole process, but now we need to make the illuminator. Oh, you know what? I didn't grab this. Okay, so let's see if we can get this now. Yes, we can. That makes us 8. Okay, awesome. Hopefully we never have to make that again. I didn't get the advanced alloy out of here either. Man, I'm so bad at this. There's a lot of overlap when I'm crafting these things right now, so we're gonna use this reinforced glass for pretty much everything we make right now. Now, is that everything? Okay, so we have the scanner. So this is the first block that's gonna get placed down. And essentially what this does is it takes a lot of power. I wanna say it's 1 million. I might have read it wrong. It might be I want to say it's 850,000 EU to scan an item, but I was messing around with it in a creative world earlier, and I want to say it's actually, it seemed like more than that. It might be 8.5 million if I read the amount of zeros wrong, but there were no commas. So I took a quick glance. I think it was 850,000, but I guess we'll find out because we're actually going to scan a piece of Iridium today. You guys might have noticed in here, I do have the one piece. This is the holy grail. It took me forever to find. Those 3 to 5 hours of prepping were pretty much like 2 hours of me trying to find a piece of Iridium. I don't know if I'm really unlucky or it just takes a while, but yes, that's how long it took me. So what we're going to do is actually just move this up here, and we got to do even more crafting because we're going to be getting now called a pattern storage. And essentially what this is it's a block that is going to go adjacent to the scanner and adjacent to the replicator. So essentially it's just going to be sandwiched in between the two. And this is going to store everything we scan. Now this is great because there are, I believe you can scan things and put them onto these crystal memory things, which is why it says empty here, and you can scan over them. But this essentially is just like an infinite amount of stored patterns that you can have. So it's a block that'll sit there, and instead of having to worry about losing things or moving them around or, you know, scanning something and then scanning over it and then wanting to have it again, we can make this, and it's a little expensive, but we can throw it down and it'll just store everything. We can cycle through patterns in it, all that good stuff. So this one requires me to make mining lasers, and you guys have commented on the fact that I've not made a mining laser or a mining drill yet for myself. So I actually got resources to make 3, and you might see that we got the lathing tool, a brand new one, and 3 iron turning blanks, which means that we can craft 3 of these. We've also got the 9 advanced alloy, the redstone that we need, and I actually think I might have missed out on making energy crystals, so I might need to go and craft some more of these later, but yeah, we will do the lathing first. So we come over here, and we actually need to get some insulated copper cable out, because we gotta hook up this electric kinetic generator to the turning table. Now, I really hope I don't screw this up, but what we're gonna do is we throw in an iron turning blank in there, and we can start lathing this. So let's take a look back here, because I didn't actually look on the wiki. So I wanna say that these are 2 out of 5, this is 3 out of 5, and this is 4 out of 5. So I really hope we don't screw up, but I think it's 4 out of 5, 3 out of 5, and then 2 on all of these. I think this is right. Handle. Is this a handle? Yes, it is. Okay, so that is correct. So we're going to do that for all of these. And I think we might not need this lathing tool. I made another one, but oh, no, no. Oh my gosh. I screwed up, boys. I screwed up. I clicked too fast. Okay, I'm going to hop off camera and we're going to fix this. We'll fix this. Okay guys, crisis averted. I did actually have to spend an okay chunk of time going mining because I realized I was out of diamonds. So of course I went off camera and I got the new iron turning blank, which wasn't difficult to get, but then I went and I made the 3 energy crystals we're going to need. So I did have to go mining again, which was unfortunate, but it actually didn't take me very long, I guess, to find a diamond vein, but whatever. So this thing's been running, which is actually possibly a mistake, but I don't even know what to do with this. Like, do I keep it as a reminder that I'm not good at this game, or what's up? Like, I don't know. Okay, so we'll get the iron turning blank. Let's not screw this one up. So 4 out of 5, 3 out of 5. Oh. Oh, okay, this one broke. I was so scared there. Okay, there we go. And there we go. Okay, so handle. Thank God we got that. Okay, so now we can start working on making these mining lasers. So we essentially have everything here. We just need to make more of these electronic circuits into the advanced circuits. So we need to make 3 of those, because we're making 3 of these mining lasers, of course. And so we'll leave 1 out of here. And you know what? I forget what order they're in, so I'm always just going to shift click this. So we're going to grab 3, and we're going to get the rest of this out of there. And let's see if we can click. Oh, we can't do it because of the energy crystals. Okay, so those are going to go right there. The handle goes down there. These go right here, I think. Let's just put all of them in. And the redstone goes right. No, no, no. My gosh, it all falls out. My life is ruined. That was atrocious. That was an astronomically large mistake. It actually wasn't that bad, but it's kind of obnoxious. Okay. So, did I do something wrong? did I do something wrong? Handle, advanced circuit, advanced alloy. What did I do wrong? Energy crystal? Huh. Okay. Redstone. I don't know what I'm doing wrong here. This is right. Okay, guys, so I'm gonna go figure out what I'm doing wrong here. Okay, I have no idea, because I literally just picked this out, put it back down, and it gave me the mining laser. So I don't know. I really don't. What the heck? Guys, I don't know what's happening right now. Give me the mining laser. Dude, what is going on right now? What is this? I don't even know what's happening right now. Okay, we'll give it another shot. We'll give it one more shot. Okay, please. There we go. Okay. It worked. Okay. That almost just ruined the episode, guys. That was rough. I don't know what the heck that was, but that was freaking me out for a second. Another handle. Shift click it. Another handle. There we go. Okay. Okay. Nobody freak out. We're all good there. So now we have our own mining laser, which is going to get stored right there for the time being. We should actually store most of this in here for now, because we do have to do a little bit of work. So obviously this is all work, but there is some stuff that we need to do that's a little bit more complicated when it comes to crafting. So we've got this CF powder here, and I made this CF sprayer. And it's got a little bit of construction foam. That's what the CF is for, if you didn't know. It's got 2 buckets of construction foam in there. And we got some sand here, which we'll talk about in a little bit. But the reason we have to do this is because we need to make this reinforced stone. And if you try clicking on it, there is no pattern for it. So I don't know if you could craft this before, but now what you need to do is you need to make iron scaffolding, which is what we're going to do right now. And then you spray construction foam onto that. And then you can use sand to speed up the process. So what we're going to do is we're going to place it down somewhere in here. Let's put it down right here. It kind of spreads out weird, so we're just going to do like 9 of these. And what you can do, if you're curious as to how you make the actual like foam that you're putting into the sprayer, is let's mine this block right here. Nope. Oh, that was a big mistake. Oh, no, actually, we can fly. That wasn't a big mistake. So let's go somewhere that I can actually mine down a block. So how about right here? Okay. So we got a bucket of water. You put that down, and then you take this CF powder and you right click on it, and it uses it, and then it makes it all nasty. And then you take the CF sprayer and you right click and it sucks it up. And then you can see you get another bucket of that in here. So all very nice and good. So then we come over here and we right click, and it's turned into reinforced construction foam. It consumes, I believe, 100 per block that we're using up. And then we take this sand and we click on it, and boom, there we go. So hopefully this isn't too annoying to mine up. I hear it's as hard to mine as obsidian, so that is less than ideal. Maybe, oh, guys, maybe. Okay, here's what we do. Here's what we do. We take the mining laser, we're gonna go charge this puppy up, and then we're gonna shoot that with it. But I'm gonna go outside and I'm gonna experiment a little bit first, because, oh, what is this? Oh, that thing's still running up there. You know what, we'll charge this up real quick first. The electric thing is still running. What, can I not charge this in here? What the heck? Oh my gosh. I don't know. I guess I can't charge that in there. Well, that's killing the mood. That's killing the mood. Okay, so we gotta shut this thing off up here first, because this is just chugging through power. Okay, so if I can't charge that in there, then I might need to just go off camera and mine these again. I'm going off camera a lot today, guys, but hopefully you don't mind. Okay, so mission accomplished. We now have 9 reinforced stone. I hope I never have to do that again with a diamond pick, because before I didn't really regret just having a diamond pick that I was using, and you guys were always like, oh, make the drills, make the laser, and I was like, yeah, it's okay. But right there, having a non-enchanted diamond pick, that was rough. That took a lot, like, it didn't take that long, but that was annoying. So now we can actually get back to crafting, and we need to... We got the advanced machine casing, we can make the circuits. Now we need to make these crystal memory thingamajiggers, and essentially you can't click on them But what you can do is you can type in crystal memory, and you can see that there is a raw crystal memory thing, and that requires us to make silicon dioxide and have obsidian dust, and we need two of these. So I have the obsidian dust that I got, and then we have 40 clay dust, and that is because you can make silicon dioxide using the thermal centrifuge at 250 heat, so it shouldn't take very long to heat up, with 4 clay dust to make 1 silicon dioxide, and we need 10, so of course I have 40. So we can actually come over here and throw these in the thermal centrifuge. It should heat up relatively quickly, and I hope it doesn't take too long to actually produce this, because the only reason I left this to do on camera was because I thought it'd be fun to show something else being used in the thermal centrifuge, but if it does take a while, it should produce one at a time from 5 of these, so it shouldn't be an issue, but we can get back to some other crafting while we do that. So we're gonna leave this all in here, and we have the obsidian dust, so we need to make another one of the advanced circuits. So we go back to the pattern storage, and we have the advanced machine casing, so we need to make the last advanced circuit. So I guess I could have just made all of these into advanced circuits initially, but whatever, it's fine, it's in the past now. So let's see how this is doing. Oh, okay, it got sucked out. Right. Okay, I was confused a little bit at first as to where it went. So that'll be the pattern storage. We'll finish making that in a bit, but now what we need to make is going to be what all this expensive stuff in this top chest is for. So I'm going to be dumping a lot of this back in here just so that we can open up some space. We'll put the iridium back. We'll leave the advanced circuit there. We've got all this random junk that can go back in here. And we're going to use that. So yeah, most of this stuff can just go back in here and sit there, because we're going to need a lot of space for what we're doing now, which is going to be making the replicator. Now, this is where all the magic happens. So when you get the pattern and you're good to go, you go to the replicator, and that's where you put the UU matter in. Chances are we're going to transport it manually, most likely, but it's also going to take a while to actually get 1,000 to fill up universal fluid cells. So maybe we won't manually transport it, but this is going to take 2 reinforced stone, so we already have that. We've got the reinforced glass, so I actually do need the stone out of here. And then we're going to need to make an MFE, 2 high voltage transformers, and teleporters. Now, everything is really cheap in here except the teleporters, and that takes a lot of advanced circuits and some diamonds and some glass fiber cables and all that. So that is what all this stuff is for. So first things first, I believe we want to actually make the high voltage transformers, which require an advanced rebattery, a regular electronic circuit. So those are what those are for right there, the electronic circuits. And then they take 2 insulated gold cables each, so that'll be 4 of those. And they take a medium voltage transformer, which is what this right here is for us to craft. So we craft the basic machine casings, craft the medium voltage transformers, and then we throw this in there, and we can make the high voltage transformer and high voltage transformer. So there we go. So we got that, and now we need to make the MFE, which is relatively easy to make. So come up here and grab another 8 iron plating. We grab these 4 energy crystals, and I believe it was 4 more insulated gold cable. So we're going to take that, put the insulated gold cable. Oh, you know what? I forgot. We need to craft this first. So there we go. Now, one thing that you guys mentioned, and I saw it in one of the comments, I haven't replied to the comments yet when I'm about to record this video. I typically go through and do that when I'm uploading the video or the next video, but someone commented on me crafting, and they said that it's actually fine as long as I have things prepared and advanced in these chests like I always do. So again, always feel free to let me know if it bothers you guys in super long crafting episodes like this. I don't mind doing this off camera, but I do think it's nice to be able to show you guys kind of what it takes to do all of it. So I don't know what these are for exactly, but we're going to make some more of these advanced circuits. We're going to need a lot of them this time. I don't even know if we have enough right now to make... Oh, okay, we got perfect amounts to make all of them. Good, good. So we got those 12 advanced circuits. And now we can go... Oh, these are for the frequency transmitters. That's what those are for. So these will make the frequency transmitters. We take these 3, put them with another 3, and we got the frequency transmitters. And now, can we go through and make this? We've got the cable up here, we've got the advanced machine casing, and we've got the diamonds. So we should be able to make these. Can we shift click it in there? No, we cannot. Unfortunate, because it's kind of annoying to put together, but we can do this, this, and what was the very bottom part of it? The diamond. Okay. So there we go. Teleporter. Throw another one of these in. Teleporter and another one. There we go. It's unfortunate we can't play around with these, but such is crafting. So these across the top. MFE. Teleporters in the middle. So much clicking. And oh, nope. That is a... There we go. So we now have the replicator, which means that we can finish off crafting. If all the stuff over here is done, it is in fact done. We have the silicon dioxide. We can come and grab, oh, we already have the obsidian dust. I feel like I'm playing the mine chem, which I messed around with a little bit in my old Ethos mod pack series. But we get these crystal memories that are raw, and what we need to do is take them to an electric furnace or any furnace, and we cook them down, and then they become empty, and we could scan stuff onto these, as far as I'm aware. Unfortunately, they don't stack, so stay here, gotta mess around with it a little bit, pull them out when they're ready, and there we go. So now we're good to actually go and craft this, so we need our two mining lasers, the circuit, the machine casing, and... Are we missing anything else? This would be for the pattern storage. It's just going to be the reinforced stone, I think. Okay, so machine casing, crystal, that, circuit, and mining lasers. There we go, pattern storage. So all that time, I don't actually know how long that was to make it, but all the time and resources put into making these three machines right here. Now, it actually comes down to putting them down and using them, and I'm actually going to grab this piece of iridium so that we can come downstairs and start messing around with them. So, over here, still generating UU matter. We're at 76 millibuckets right now. This thing's still going strong. These have been drained an okay amount. Oh, the police are outside at my college campus. Hopefully you guys can't hear that too loud. But the whole idea that I was thinking is we should be able to actually, if we can... We can have a fluid ejector upgrade here, so we should be able to eject this into the replicator, which means we want the replicator to be directly adjacent to this. So we'd want to put the replicator right here, and it looks really fancy, so you know it must be special. And then we want to have the pattern storage between the two, like I said, sandwiching it. This does not require any energy or anything. And then we have the scanner, which another fancy machine. These are also futuristic-y, but this one goes right here, and this one looks super cool inside. So this one does need power again, and essentially what this is going to do is we're gonna put the iridium ore in here, and there's no energy, so I believe you need to supply this with a steady supply of energy, which might be a little bit of an issue. We might have to disconnect both of these machines to actually hook this up. But first things first, what we're gonna try is just mining behind here and hooking up all of these in a line and seeing if that'll work with the gold cable. So I hope it works. If it doesn't though, we'll have to disconnect everything but the scanner. Okay, so it is scanning it very, very slowly. It is a little bit glitchy because this thing is getting power input into its system right now, I believe. It's not filling up. I think it probably has a pretty big internal buffer, but it is scanning it. You can see it's at 3%. And this thing should be going up really... Oh, this thing isn't actually going up that slow. That's why I thought we might need to disconnect it. We can always try that if we wanted to drop it down right here. So if I were to kind of mine down here and drop this below, we could circumvent all of this. So let's try that. We'll break this and put it down here. So let's see how that runs. Not seeing a huge difference, probably because this thing is getting power. This isn't filling up at all, though. Maybe this doesn't fill up. I don't know. But you can see it's scanning. So there's no way this is going to be done today. I guess I'll just reset this because it was going fine. Okay, guys. So we're going to call it an episode for today. I hope you enjoyed it. Pretty much the whole system is going to be the scanner is going to scan your item. It's going to take the scan results and it's going to put them into the pattern storage, which will give you the name of it. It'll give you the UU matter required and the energy required. And you can flip through the patterns and import from crystals, export from crystals. And then you can go to the replicator, which will be able to take the pattern. You can stop the process, send a single run through, or do a repeated run and repeatedly make the same thing, which is what we'll eventually do with the iridium. And this is where the UU matter is also going to go. which makes it a little bit easier if you put it adjacent to the mass fabricator and just have a fluid ejector upgrade in there. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, found it entertaining or informative and useful in any way, feel free to give it a like, as it does help me out a lot. And I will talk to you guys later.